everybody, it's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and we have picked the windiest days to plant our fruit trees. We have, right now it's nice, but every now and again we get like a 40 mile an hour gust of wind.
So if there's any sound distortion, please forgive us.
Yes. So these are our 5-in-1 apple trees. Each of these branches here is a different type of apple. So when they start bearing their fruit, we're going to see five different kinds.
What are the five different kinds for those who haven't seen these?
Honeycrisp.
Okay.
We have Braeburn. Let me turn this around here. Braeburn. Fuji. Gala. And Granny Smith.
Yeah. Well, they come from fast-growing trees, and they come nicely wrapped in burlap, right. So they're not bare-rooted.
That's right. And they've given us instructions saying, do not take the burlap off. They have been grown in this burlap, I guess, and they feel that this is the best way to plant them. So we went ahead and we planted our first one. And we put in a mixture of the original soil, which is a very rich composted leaf soil. Then we added in peat moss, we added in topsoil, and we also put in manure, composted manure. Then we put the tubes on, the plastic tubing there to protect them from voles and mice and deer chewing on them. And then Rick also built this deer netting
cage
to keep them from getting at them that way. I suppose they could still come and just nibble off the tops.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
I'll be spraying them.
And it's been staked.
Yes. Now we're going to stake them for 1 year, they said.
Yep.
And then they'll be strong enough that they can tolerate all this wind movement.
Now, we did have some crossover branches that you decided to do what with?
Right. Well, we are trying to separate them a little bit more. So we've taken jute and we've attached it gently and without binding to different branches that seem to need to be separated. And we're going to see if that works. Otherwise, we will have to take those off if they get in the way.
And why do you use clothespins?
Well, to keep it from sliding up.
Okay. The jute from sliding
Yes.
up. Okay. Well, I think it's time to start planting the other 5-in-1 apple tree and
right.
the two Alberta peach trees.
Let's get it done.
Okay.
So our son Sky came, was that last weekend, and he dug the holes for us. This soil is very rich. It's been leaf composting for years now. Last year we grew some squash in here, but other than that, it's virgin soil. So it's very nice soil, and we're going to use that as part of our mixture.
Now that's the old soil you dug out of the hole.
Correct. And I'm trying to pull out all the roots from the blackberries and the raspberries.
Good luck.
Good luck on that. Then I'm putting in a little bit of compost. A little bit of topsoil. And some peat moss. I know in some parts of the United States you can't get peat moss, but we still are able to, and we're very lucky. Now we have to see if the hole is too deep or if it's just right. We want the root, where the root and the tree meet, that has to be just on top of the soil level.
So the top of the root ball.
Yes. All right, now let me see where that... Let me see where this juncture is. All right, so right here is where the roots start. And here, where this little part is coming out a little bit, that's where you want your soil to be, right?
Not taller there. Than that, though.
Not taller. So I'm looking at where it was when they planted it, and that's how tall or how deep it needs to be.
So we really like to plant our trees a little higher, though, than soil level, mainly because this soil is going to sink a little bit, too.
It will, and trees are happier if they're a little higher than the soil, so they don't get sogged in. Their roots don't get soggy. So I think this is at a good space.
I do, too.
Now. Okay, so now I can move the rest of my soil and my amendments, and we should be good.
Good thing you have three arms.
I know. Let me put some of this topsoil around here. Hold your breath. I'm going to put in some peat moss. And then the manure. Okay, overload the cage. Little arms in there. Get in there. Okay, I've moved the cage over the tree, and this will keep out most things, except for the very tall deer. And
like me?
Yes, you're my tall deer. And now we're going to get two stakes to pound in the ground to hold this and to stabilize the tree.
Watch out, Thor.
Now we're going to anchor this wire cage to the stake just to give it a little more stability. Oh, you're using these little
zip ties.
Plastic zip ties. Get in there. They are tight.
Yes, they are. Probably could have used longer ones, but as long as I had these. There you go.
My third hand again. I like it.
I know. Comes in handy.
Now we're going to put in another anchor, a little bit less sturdy than this, but again, just to stabilize. I'm going to weave this through.
These are just little garden stakes, right?
Yep. Okay, so this goes over, and then it goes under, goes over, and then under.
Just like weaving.
Yep. Tie the twine around the actual tree trunk to keep it steady for at least 1 year. And look who's here, our first ladybug of the year. I hope he's a good one, or she. Eat lots of aphids. Uh-huh. It's very important to water these. We didn't water them as we were planting them because we really didn't want to be in a puddle of mud. But now that they're planted, we can give them a good drink and they'll be very happy. Especially since we're not going to have rain for a couple of days. They'll be extra happy when natural water comes onto them also.
Well, the apple trees are now planted, now onto the peach trees.
Onto the peaches. Compost. Peat moss. Hold your breath.
Sure is windy out.
All four of our trees are in the ground, and I'm sure they're very happy to now be out of their pots, into the soil, in the sunlight, and receiving water so that they can grow. The ones that are blossoming will be very happy to have the bees coming and getting them pollinated, and we can hardly wait. We'd like to thank Fast Growing Trees. We can hardly wait to see what these trees do over the summer. And we pretty well deer-proofed everything, hopefully. Not only the wide perimeter around the whole thing, but each tree is also protected. So,
well, again, Fast Growing Tree says that we should receive full-size fruit this very first year.
Yes, they did. Looking forward to it.
Yeah.
If you enjoyed this video and my wild hair, which I think I'll call Gone with the Wind hair, please give us a thumbs up. We truly appreciate that. And if you have comments, questions, or tips, we'd love to hear them. Thank you. And if you'd like to become part of our garden family, remember, down here is that little subscribe button.
Well, we hope everybody remains safe.
Healthy.
Social distancing, which we've done to our trees. So, all we need now is to buy masks for our trees.
No, they're not going to need masks.
Okay.
They're fine. Bye for now.
Well, you ready to pick some apples?
Yes.
Okay, let's get going.
Connect with us on YouTube.